Hello Gundam fans, this is Prime92, and today I'll be looking at the 10144 High Grade Gundam Airmaster from the Gundam X series. So this is the mobile armor mode. Pretty nice looking jet. Lower half is the normal Gundam affair. Bend the knees, fold the feet down, rotate the waist, yep. But I do like the front half. And you can mount it on an action base, just like the High Grade Wing. Just take this little panel off. I really like that, how they're incorporating the mounting points into the mold. It's pretty cool. And yes, you are supposed to have the arms bent in this mode. I don't really like it, but that's how you can mount the guns better, I suppose. Although, maybe you're supposed to mount them with the handles up. I don't know. I don't think it really matters. But you got them like that. And it has missiles, which you can take off the little mounting unit. So if you don't like the little holes on the top and you don't want the missiles, you can do that. But if you got the missiles, you might as well mount them right. And there it is, all armed up. Oops. It's just on a peg. No big deal. And that's on a peg too. No big deal. There we go. That's what happens when you do several takes. But yeah, it's all right in this mode. I do like it. So let's get to transformation. I'll leave these missiles on. So, lower half is, like I said, normal stuff. Rotate the waist. Straighten the legs. Straighten the toes. And there is the lower half. Now, I do like the upper half. And I didn't even know that this part here is actually the top of the torso. I didn't know you're supposed to put it there. It kind of fills in the front. But obviously there's still a cap right there. Yeah, they try. So, pull that off. Fold the back of the back here. Nice and flush with the backpack. I like it. Rotate the entire top down. I swear it's supposed to lock into place. This is my one big problem with the kit, and if it's only mine, I'm sorry, but it is a problem with my kit. It goes down, and this part goes down too, which is kind of neat. But I don't see a way for it to lock. It feels like it should. It pushes down, but it doesn't. So either it's the way it's designed, or it's just mine, or I'm dumb. Or all three, I don't know. And then just fold the wings down and out of the way to the back. Like that. These parts can go down. And then take this part, plug it into the chest, and pop on the head. And that is the Gundam Airmaster in mobile suit mode. And he looks pretty good. He does feel a little tiny. He's not. But he does feel like it. I feel he's small. He does have very few stickers. The forehead camera, back of the head, the eyes, and the little black on the shoulder armor here. That's it. So very good in that department. And aside from the torso not feeling like it wants to stay in place, this leg does come off a little too easily. I'm pretty sure it's just mine because the other one's fine. So I'm not going to hold that against it, but yeah, the torso is a little annoying. But it does stay together, and it's not back heavy because of how everything is pretty, flush against the body. So it does look pretty good, and it is hold together. The head goes up and down, and forward and back. And rotates. Arms can go forward at the polycap and rotate. Kind of hard to do it with all the stuff here. Go out. Rotate below the shoulder, but it's very stiff. It actually pops off the ball joint before it rotates. Elbow joint to elbow. Ball joint to wrist. You got a swivel waist. Don't really know if you can count that. I don't know. Ball-jointed front skirts, you can separate. hinge side skirts. Legs will do the jiggy jig jig. Very tight. And they'll go forward, a little back, out, rotate at the hip, a nice double joint knee. Got the foot armor that moves, hinge ankle goes forward and back, and a ball jointed foot, and the hinge toes. And I suppose you can move the wings if you want, but they do, because of the way they are now, they do hit things and pop things off, and I just leave them on the back. Kind of looks like a cloak. So, yeah, I think the articulation is pretty good. It's not amazing. It does have good angles, and the arms are pretty good from all the stuff in the way. And there's that torso. But yeah, I think it's pretty good articulation. Well, you've already seen the weapons. You got the missiles, and you got the beam rifles. And you only have the one set of hands because this is all it holds. It has nothing else. It doesn't have another gun, doesn't have a beam saber, doesn't even have a shield. Maybe you could use the wings as shields, but I don't think it did. Because I'm pretty sure this guy was more like a gun, like a run-and-gun kind of fighter. Like, fly in, do the damage, fly out. And you can also mount these onto the side skirt, which I do like. But I do kind of like putting them back on the arms. Now, I wish they could go up higher, but because of mounting on the side skirt, the pegs had to be farther farther up on the beam rifle. Yeah, but that's okay. So those are the weapons. Not a lot. Wish I had more. Wish they maybe included something special, but they didn't. So yeah, not much in the way of accessories. Now, I did say that I felt this guy was small. And maybe that's the wrong word. He feels tiny. He's not, like, short in stature. He's actually the same height as all the other mobile suits, but he's built. I think that's what it is, because here is the high-grade Wing Gundam, and they're the same height, but the Wing Gundam, he feels and looks, I think, a little more substantial? Is that the word? They both have wings, and he has a lot of stuff on the top, and he doesn't look bulky? I don't know. Here's the X Divider. Once again, I feel the X is a little bulkier. I don't know. I think I'm crazy. And, of course, here is the Exia. Real great. So you can see, Exia is more of an average-sized mobile suit, so these guys are, well, they're always been kind of tiny. For, the 90s. The 90s kits were tiny. So, oh, this is your video. This is your video. So that is the High Grade Air Master. It's pretty good. I like both modes. Good articulation. Wish it had more weapons. It just doesn't. Never did. I wish I could figure out how to lock his torso. That is my biggest gripe with it. And if it's just my problem, good. If it's only my kit, if I'm doing something wrong, I'm dumb, I guess. I wish I knew it. But I looked at the instructions, didn't see it. So it is a decent kit, but I think it could have been a little better. So that's about it, and I'll see you at the next review.